Here, just to take care of your mind, just to feel that need. That's worth more money. Hoping that they will be able Well, first of all, they need to be understand. I know how hard it is when you have a commander harassing you. When you need repairs in the department, and you don't have repairs. So when you, in my case, for example, I didn't harass me, I didn't remember because the elevator didn't work, and it was, I tried to collect finish for tenants. So that way we can be able to collect the signature and bring the landlord to court. If I get elected as an official, I will bring home those burdens, get the tenants united, and if you have any problem, so we can't stop the rent for all your apartments, tenants. That way we will bring down
to make out.
So also, there's a aspect that we can use, that we can use to keep it out to everybody in this community, because a lot of tenants don't know the rules. So if I get elected, I want to print out all the flyers and all the stuff that we, as a community, we can engage everybody and understand the rules. We can stand and protect our rights. Because a lot of people don't know the rights in this community. It's hard when you don't know the rights of this. The right that you don't have. And for that reason, we have to make aware, we have to educate our tenants that they have rights. And they know how to use them, those rights.
Thank you, Luis, for that answer.
My
question. Thank you so much for all you do. It's a need in our community.
I remember
my mother's a long attendant, and I remember growing up, we would go into ancient complexes and take the elevator, somewhere on the elevator was broken, we'd take the stairs and just smell that some of the ancient complexes. That's no way to live. And that's just from the outside looking in. When you get inside some of these apartments, including Bailey, including Marble Hill, important tenants, we know that there's no repairs going on for a long amount of time. And it's not that, you know, sometimes they're going to tell us we don't have the money for it. It's not in the budget. This is New York City. We're one of the richest cities in the world. Everyone can eat.
Caring about the art as
education harder time and time again. So it's like us having targeted and pushed out of school for harsh punishments. Methods such as inspection of higher ups, harsh discipline policies, proof to the higher ups, and an employment for our communities. With that said,
will you stand with us and switch them across the state to ensure that the wrong public schools discipline and the practices on the way disproportionately targets students of color, particularly Black, Latino, LGBTQ, and student with disabilities through the implementation and restored practices and alternatives to punitive methods currently used in school?
Will you also ensure the New York State Department of Education that it has $400 million from the state of young people and invest in counselors and social workers, along with the other supportive methods outside schools like DBU, jobs, and enterprise for low income?
That's it. How will you ensure that our communities are safe and supportive towards living into Q5A and young people of color?
Thank you so much for your question. I feel like at your age, I was kind of shy too, so I'd be like, kind of talking like this. But like, I really appreciate that question. It's not easy standing up in front of a crowd and talking that real talk. And one of the main reasons I wanted to run for office was because of the young people in our community. I wanted to make sure that they had every opportunity to grow and live the best lives they could, no matter what their background was. I didn't feel like we had that. So when we think about the public schools in our community, some of the most under-resourced, we need the most opportunity, we need more strategic spending to make sure that our kids have everything that they need. And we don't currently have that. When I look at the school to prison pipeline that actually exists in our community and how disciplining some students, because the teacher might not understand culturally what's going on, the teacher might not understand what's going on at home with the student. There's more education that needs to be done with our educators to make sure that they're doing the best job they can for you. And that means coming right back to the community. That means establishing some task forces in different neighborhoods, look into our public schools and figure out what's going on here, how can we do the best for our students, how can we make sure they get the best education possible. With regards to making it safer for students of color, for students of LGBT backgrounds, that comes back to education. At the end of the day, there's a resolution in City Hall right now that encourages the Department of Education to teach LGBT history, more African American history, more Latino history. And believe it or not, my current councilmember disagreed with that. So, comes January 2nd, when I'm in office, after you open in September 12th, the 14th district council member will push for that resolution to make sure our public schools teach LGBT.
In the classroom, leading training, we know we have the knowledge, we have the training. Every year we go training. So it's not a teacher's fault. It's the policies of the New York Department of Education that makes it difficult for the students in the classroom. And they need to be by anything. Those are simple as well. And let me go back to the question of the team. We know the 24 schools. It's a city that closed the last administration, closed these 7 schools, trade schools. Trade schools that provide training for students, give opportunity to those students to succeed. So right now we don't have more trade schools in the city. In the last 12 years, the city has closed at least 12 of the 17 schools. So we need to bring back those schools. So that way we provide opportunity for our students. Even if you don't want to go to college, at least you have a training. You can provide like clothing, like nutrition. So we don't have that anymore because the city closes all the training schools. And the majority of them, of course, for big change and clothing another way. So we have to make sure that we bring more those schools and training schools, plumbing, carpentry, electricity, computer. So So we don't have that. So I'm make sure if I become a city council, I will bring back this school because I thought in the past to keep those schools alive. Unfortunately, because the city had another policy, they closed the schools. But we have to bring back this school. Imagine you don't finish college, but at least you have an opportunity to be a plumber, mechanic. You have something in your life that you can invest in the future, and you can provide opportunity for your family. Right now, we don't have that because the city closed. So I make sure if I become a city councilman, I will fight to open more schools in this area.
Information about what hospital have beneficial for us to
We go to private hospital and we go to the common hospital. So we have to make sure that every patient knows that we have hospital in this area. And another thing is, we engage in this community in that aspect. So please, there's nothing we can do if we don't get together and do it the right way. So there's no magic solution. We have to live together.
Thanks for that question. I, Amanda, being a supporter of Karen Sanders, I think when the question of public hospitals comes up, of course they're going to stay open. And of course we're going to make sure the funding stays there. Like, I know the service that public hospitals provide for our community, but unfortunately there's people in the administration in the city and in the state that don't see public hospitals as that much of an asset to our community. I don't think they understand what's going on the ground. What I see public hospitals doing is accepting a lot of people into their hospitals, giving them quality care, and alleviating some of the private hospitals from having such a backlog or having a lot of people. We work together in a great system so far, and public hospitals are key. They're the backbone of our health industry, even in New York City. You have my word, I'm going to protect public hospitals, make sure that the funding doesn't go down not 1 cent. And let me tell you, I'm proud to be endorsed by 1199 SEIU. And they are proud to be endorsed by 1199 SEIU. And you have my word for that. Now, about ambulatory care. And you're right, consultants. I dealt with them in the past. They try to train every dollar of a community of a budget that they offer you. So, what I would offer as councilmen, as we start to organize and engage our community, how about an ambulatory care unit that's owned by us as the grown? Yeah. How about a longer ambulatory care unit? We all have to do it. It's not just a dream, it's not just hope, it's real. It's coming January 2nd, we're going to start working on that.
Resources to buy clients, energy appliances, to get all departments in reducing energy. That way we have better bills in our room. Because I was trying to get my clients, and I said I had the city, but the client was covered by any reduced cost to me, and they said no. So I'm not sure that 25% in this way, which is 25%, I make sure the city will provide more subsidized for those items, those products that wasn't even made sure the manager that I'm selling will be the next. So this time it's not hard to get all the money, and I'm gonna like to do five magic words saying I'm gonna do it right now. Now we have to go through the 3 months process. So when we have to engage our elected officials and bring a bill to promote the cost of mission in the city. Not only the amount, also through the institutions. I see the schools close at night and they are consuming like the air conditioning gone off, which is ridiculous, nobody else is there. And we have to make sure that every building, every institution reduce the consumption, because it's a waste of money and energy at the same time. And make sure that it does provide bills that those most schools and not not cost energy. Thank you.
Let's take a call turn two before you turn out.